We are beginning tonight with continuing coverage of a high-profile cold case on the Central Coast.
After 41 years, a Seaside murder suspect made his first court appearance on these charges today. Prosecutors arraigned James Mason on charges of murder for the death of Christian Lopes. Police say that the crime happened during a fight at a party back in 1969. Just days ago, police arrested Mason in Texas. Action News reporter Robbie Kapoor is live tonight with more on his first court appearance.
Well, Dan, with Mason's arraignment just weeks after his Texas arrest, authorities tell us this case just reinforces the notion that justice will be served no matter how long it takes.
As 58-year-old James Mason stepped into a Monterey County courtroom Thursday,
finally, somebody's responsible.
41 years of anguish are coming to an end for the Lopes family. In December 1969, 19-year-old Chris Lopes was killed during a melee at the Del Monte Manor in Seaside. Though dozens of people were believed to be present at the time of the slaying, no one spoke out until now.
It is just as every other case we prosecute, no different just because it is from 1969.
Without DNA samples handy, Monterey County Deputy District Attorney Meredith Silman credits Seaside Police Detective Nick Borges for finding the evidence needed to indict.
We saw that this was a very provable case based on the evidence, and we filed the charges.
The law finally caught up with James Mason 2 weeks ago in Texas. He waived extradition and will be back in court next week for a preliminary hearing where Deborah Lopes and family will be waiting for him.
What does this tell you that you have investigators out there constantly hoping, looking to solve this case?
It tells me that anybody commits murder, they'll catch you if it's 20, 30, 40, 50 years from now. So beware.
Investigators strongly believe that there were other folks on site of that murder scene some 40-plus years ago, and they hope those folks will step forward now. Dan?
All right. Thank you, Rami. Mason, meantime, is due back in court October 28th.